Your Hello Great People African Traveler again. It's another time to review some of the major urban centers in Kenya. From the previous review of the top 10 urban centers in Kenya, many of you complained that some of the major cities were missing, such as Kericho, Kakamega, and I promised you guys that we're going to do another top 10 major towns that are yet to be classified as cities. So today I'm going to review just the major towns in Kenya that are yet to be classified as cities. So it's going to be just like the other video. It's going to be in terms of the build-up area of the cities, not mostly population. From my visit, I'm just going to review mostly of how I saw the city. So now first on the line is going to be Kericho. It's the biggest town in Kericho County, located in the highland west of the Kenyan Rift Valley. It stands on the edge of Mau Forest. Kericho has a warm, temperate climate, making it an ideal location for agriculture and in particular, large-scale cultivation of tea. So there's a lot of tea in this town. It's strategically located along Kenya's Western Tourist Circuit, with access to Lake Victoria, Masai Mara National Reserve, as well as Ruma National Park. Kericho is the hometown of the Kipsigis community, who are part of the Kalenjin people. The town hosts Africa's largest Singh Gurdwara, I think is an Indian temple, and the second largest Catholic cathedral in Kenya. So, yeah, and also the town, Kericho, is reputed to hold the record for the highest number of hail occurrence in a year. Kericho is reputed to hold the record highest number of hailstorm ever to be recorded in a year, and that was around 1965. Yeah, just to tell you guys that it rains. When it rains, it pours in Kericho. It rains a lot. Actually, the day I was shooting, I couldn't really shoot well because it was just raining. Like every time I passed the town, the high chances of you just finding rain in the town is super high. The county has a population of 900,000 people as of 2019 population census, but actually the town has a population of about 105,000 people. So that was the 10th biggest town. So actually, guys, we're moving from the number 10 to the first biggest town that are yet to be classified as city. Second in line is Meru. So Meru for me is the 9th biggest city in Kenya in terms of build-up area. So Meru is actually a city in the eastern Kenya, in the eastern side of Kenya. It's the headquarters of Meru County. It's located on the northern eastern slope of Mount Kenya. The town consists of two main parts, central Meru and the junction town, which grew in the north around the junction of B6 and the road to Maua. The city is predominantly populated by the Meru people, a Bantu ethnic group. So Meru town is a commercial capital of the northern and eastern part of Kenya. It hosts the central bank currency serving center, which currently serves the northern half of Kenya. It also has so many other banks. All the leading banks in Kenya, you will find them in the town of Meru. It is also an educational center serving the northern side of Kenya. So many of the institutions are serving the northern side of Kenya. You will find them in Meru. There are so many high school, primary, university, colleges. So Meru town is also a jumping off place for people going to Samburu or Buffalo Spring National Reserve or Lewa Conservancy, which are on the north side of Kenya. So Meru being the serving center for the northern side of Kenya, people going to the northern side of Kenya, either Isiolo, Samburu, Moyale, Ethiopia, you know, go through Meru. And with that, the town has really grown and has so many of the major hotels such as Hotel Alba, Kirimba Lodge, Elsa, among so many others. So yeah, this is a commercial center serving the northern Kenyan in terms of cash flow. Meru is one of the towns in the country that has one of the highest circulation of money, liquid cash, especially due to the number of businesses running in the town, serving the rest part of Kenya, especially the north, and also the lucrative mirror business that fetches billions of money on a daily basis. So the population of the county of Meru is about 1.5 million as of 2019 census. The town itself has a population of about 240,000. Now, the next town is going to be Nyeri, as per my view. It was the headquarters of the central Kenya. We used to have provinces. We used to have 8 provinces, and one of it was central province, and Nyeri was the headquarters. So Nyeri is a town situated in the central highlands of Kenya, the county headquarters of Nyeri County. The town is situated around 150 kilometers north of Kenya's capital, Nairobi, in the country's densely populated and fertile central highland, lying between the eastern base of the Aberdare Nyandarua Range, which form part of the east end of the Great Rift Valley and the western slope of Mount Kenya. Nyeri also hosts the tomb of Robert Baden Powell, the founder of the Scouting Movement. It's also the hometown for the late Nobel laureate Wangari Maathai. The town is also home of the Dedan Kimathi University of Technology, founded by the local community in the early 70s as an institute of technology and converted into a fully-fledged university around 2012. The majority of Nyeri residents are members of the Kenya largest community, ethnic community, the Kikuyu. In addition to its homegrown university, Dedan Kimathi University, Karatina College University, Nyeri hosts satellite campuses of various major public universities such as University of Nairobi and Kenyatta University. The other major is the National Police Training College, situated in Kiganjo, which is just 10 kilometers from the town. Kenya police train, like most of the Kenyan police you see on the streets, most of them pass through Kiganjo. This is a very fertile land. It produces a lot of coffee, tea, grains. The population of Nyeri County is about 760,000 as of 2019 census, and the town has a population of about 120,000. So let's go to the next town, which is going to be number 7. This is the town that you guys really asked and really complained that missed from the previous file. So yeah, so right now we have Kakamega. So most of you, my number 7 town was going to be Kakamega. So Kakamega is a town in the western Kenya lying about 30 kilometers north of the equator. It is the headquarters of the Kakamega County. Kakamega is just 52 kilometers north of Kisumu, which is Kenya's third biggest city. So Kakamega is considered to be the heartland of the Luhya tribe. This is the second biggest tribe in Kenya. The average elevation of Kakamega is around 1,500 meters high. Kakamega serves as the headquarters of Mumias Sugar, previous Kenya's largest sugar processing company located in the town of Mumias. So Kakamega was the scene of the Kakamega gold rush in the early 1930s, fueled partly by the report of the geologist Albert Ernest Gitson. Yeah, so there's also a place called Ikolomani, which basically came from the word gold mine. There was a rush for gold mining in the town around 1930, and it was projected to have a lot of gold. I don't think it's the same case today, but we still have some gold around Ikolomani where people still mine the gold. Kenya is not a big producer of gold. Within the town, you also have a very big university, the Masinde Muliro University of Science and Technology, which is a new institution of higher learning created by the Act of Parliament in December 2006. Which is in the heart of Kakamega town. The university has really spurred a lot of growth within Kakamega, and it has really brought in a lot of beauty. It's very near to the stadium, and with that, the place really looks beautiful, just because you have this major university and some distance from it you have this big stadium. So have Kakamega Forest, which is the main tourist destination in the area. Another attraction is to be the Crying Stone of Ilesi. You receive very high amount of rainfall because of the Kakamega Forest, which is still a remnant of the rainforest that stretch west through Uganda. The population of Kakamega County is 1.9 million as of 2019 census, and the town is roughly about 150,000 people. My number 6 town is going to be Naivasha. So Naivasha is a large town in Nakuru County. So Nakuru has 2 major towns, which is Nakuru itself, which is the 4th largest city, and we have Naivasha, which to my list is among the top largest cities in Kenya as well. It lies about 90 kilometers northwest of Nairobi. So the main industry is agriculture, especially floriculture. So when you come to Naivasha, you'll see a lot of tourism and a lot of greenhouses. So most of the cut flower that is exported from Kenya usually come from Naivasha. And actually, Kenya is among the biggest exporters of flowers in the world. So Naivasha is also a popular tourist destination, such as Hell's Gate National Park, the main location for the Lion King. If you watch Lion King, they took the topography of the area from Hell's Gate. So you also have Mount Longonot, which is just nearby. We also have Lake Naivasha. So many people also come to the town just to observe bird life as well as hippopotamus behavior, as well as other wildlife. So Naivasha is a place where you will just walk on the street and you see giraffes, gazelles, like it's magical. It's a magical. You also have Crescent Island where you can just walk by the wildlife. You know, it's one of the magnificent places, not mentioning the number of beautiful resorts within the town. This is one of the best places you'll come and enjoy, not the town. The town is super, looks super dry, and but the beauty of Naivasha is not in the town. The beauty of Naivasha is within the lake, where you find the beach hotels, the wildlife, and the tourist spot that you'll go and watch. Naivasha is in Nakuru County, which has a population of about 2.2 million as of 2019 census, and the town itself has a population of about 200,000. So let me go to the fifth largest town that had to be classified as city, and I call it Machakos. Machakos, also called Masaku, about 63 kilometers southeast of Nairobi. It's very close to Nairobi. It is the capital of the Machakos County. Kenya's people who live here, mostly the Akamba ethnic community. Machakos is surrounded by hilly terrain with a high number of family farms. In 1887, Machakos became the first administrative center for the British colony. The capital was moved later on, around 1899, when Machakos was passed by the Uganda Railway. So this was the first administrative center for the British around 1887, then later on moved to Nairobi in 1899 after the railway passed by Nairobi. Machakos is actually a bit drier, so when the British came to Nairobi, it was super green, a lot of water, and Nairobi became more strategic than Machakos. So technically, Machakos is the oldest administrative municipality in East and Central Africa for the British people. Machakos town has good road infrastructure and town planning as well. It has hilly scenery, good for camping, hiking. It's also hometown for some of the world's most beautiful sculptures made in Wamunyu. Kaloleni near Ngelani is famous for water flowing against gravity in the Katuluni Hill, a spot known as Kiamwilu, to the east of Machakos. So I took you guys some time here where water is going against gravity, and it was really magnificent. So before we go to the next, the fourth biggest urban center that is yet to be classified a city, just confirm that you've already clicked the like button. You've also subscribed. Yeah, my fourth biggest urban center in Kenya will be Malindi. So Malindi is a town on the Malindi Bay at the mouth of Sabaki River, lying on the Indian Ocean coast of Kenya. It is 120 kilometers north of Mombasa. It is the largest urban center in Kilifi County as well, and the second largest urban center on the coastline of Kenya. Tourism is the major industry in Malindi. The city is popular among Italian tourists. I also did a video on Malindi. You can check on the link above. Malindi is served with a domestic airport and a highway between Mombasa and Lamu as well. The nearby Watamu Resort and Gedi Ruins, also known as Gedi, are south of Malindi, developed as part of the emerging Swahili civilization in the 5th to 10th century. Bantu-speaking farmers wear these melted iron-built timber and wattle houses thatched with palm leaves, spoke a local dialect known as Kiswahili, and engaged in a regional and sometimes long-distance trade. The resurgence of the Indian Ocean trade network at the end of the first millennium led to larger settlement, increased long-distance trade, and greater social complexity. Beginning of the 11th century, the Swahili along the coast were acting as middlemen for Somali, Egyptian, Nubians, Arab, Persians, and Indian traders. They began building walled towns, coral houses, and elites converted to Islam, often speaking Arabic. Malindi Kingdom appeared to have been formed around the 9th century AD, and to grown powerfully in two centuries before Vasco da Gama ushered the Portuguese colonization of the region, later leading to the decline of the Swahili civilization. The city of Malindi was founded around 1850 AD and was in somewhat more northerly located than the modern city today, and appeared to have destroyed around 1000 AD. So this is a town where you'll find history and you'll find a lot of fun. This is a place for you to come and enjoy the pristine beaches, super nice hotels, and You know, you can also enjoy the history in places like Gede. The population of Malindi is in a county called Kilifi and has a population of 1.4 million as of 2019 census, but the town has a population of about 120,000 people. Yeah, so we're going to the third town, and I had to realign from my previous list. I had to realign some cities just after some serious consideration on some factors. And due to that, Kisi came third, and Kisi came ahead of Thika. And this is because I considered the city planning as well as the industrial park and adjacent city. So third biggest city, I'll give it to Kisi, that is yet to be classified as city, and it's one of the cities that in the coming decade, probably with proper planning, it will be classified as a city. So Kisi is a municipality and a major urban center in southwest Kenya. It is the capital of the Kisi County. Kisi Town also served as the main urban and commercial center for the Gusii Highlands and the South Nyanza region, and the second largest town in the Greater Nyanza after Kisumu City. It is a bustling town and home of several businesses, organizations, education institutions, government agency. Kisi Municipality sits right in the center of the Western Kenya tourist circuit and includes Tabaka Soapstone Carving, Masai Mara Game Reserve, Lambo Valley Game Reserve, and the entire Lake Victoria Basin. The town continues to serve this former district, the larger South Nyanza County and the Transmara area of the Western Narok County in Commerce. Kisi Town connects the Great Rift Valley and Nairobi to Migori, Kenya-Tanzania border, has a sizable manufacturing industry. Kisi Town was originally known by the Gusii people as the Getembe. It was later named Basongo. It originated from Abasongo, referred to the British whites who lived in the town during the colonial times. So the Gusii would call them Basongo instead of Wazungus. The town is predominantly inhabited by the Gusii community, also known as the Kisi. Among the Kenyan urban areas, Kisi municipality has a relative high population density. However, the population density at 2,862 per square kilometer is relative high owing to the scarcity of land in the municipality boundaries, spurring further expansion of settlement in outlying areas. The economy of Kisi is derived from the commerce and agriculture. So the economy of Kisi is derived. The economy of Kisi town is derived in agriculture. The economy of Kisi town is derived from commerce and agriculture. So they said, yeah, the town, you can feel the town is expanding in a big way. Like the town is growing very fast. And yeah, there's a lot of need to put in structures so that it cannot affect a lot of investors in the long term when the infrastructure is put in place. So yeah, so the population of the county is about 1.3 million as of 2019 census, and the town has about a population of about 120,000 people. Yeah, so my second biggest town is going to be Thika. So I had to put it ahead of Kisi just because of the structures of the towns. There's some of the things I had to consider later on. Thika is a bit well balanced in terms of structure. You have an industrial park on one side. You have a very nice residential area on one side. You have a farmland on one side, and the town is way better structured as compared to Kisi. So with that, I had to consider Thika. So Thika is an industrial town and a major commerce hub in Kiambu County on the A2 road, just around 42 kilometers northeast of Nairobi. It lies in the highland region just northeast of the capital city of Nairobi, an elevation of about 4,900 feet above sea level. Situated in a fruit growing area, Thika specializes in fruit canning, notably pineapples. So if you've eaten Del Monte pineapples, there's a high chance, especially the slices, there's a high chance they came from this place. The production of textile and manufacturing of matches, tinplates, cans, and leather, and other leading industry are leading industries. So we have a lot of industry. We have industries such as pick and peel, if you like pick and peel, if you like Kenyan nut, if you like Bidco products. You know, this town has a lot of industries, a lot and a lot of industry. Thika is the site for the National Horticulture Research Center, which engages in agronomic research, and also a town with the highest number of institutions and industries. So, yeah, apart from industries, this town Yeah, the population of students is one of the highest. It has so many institutions leading, being the Mount Kenya University, Greater Jordan College. A lot of institutions are located in this town. The town was also very advanced infrastructure compared to so many other areas. And this is an advantage for the town being very close to Nairobi. That will give Thika an edge over so many of the other towns in Kenya. Yeah, the population of, so the town is in Kiambu County, and Kiambu is one of the most popular counties in Kenya. So with a population of about 2.4 million people as of 2019 census, and the town has a population of about 280,000 people. First in land, the city that is yet to be classified as a city is called Eldoret. The town has really developed over time, and Eldoret is a principal town in the Rift Valley region of Kenya and serves as the capital of Uasin Gishu County. So Eldoret is a principal town in the Rift Valley region of Kenya and serves as the capital of Uasin Gishu County. The town is colloquially known as Isibo Eldoret. It was established in the midst of the farms, to what was known to the settlers as Farm 64. Or Sisibo to the locals. So the locals used to say, instead of 64, so it was, they used to say it as Sisibo. Basically, the 64 came from the 103 kilometers or 64 miles from the newly built railway. So it was about 64 kilometers, 64 miles. So instead of, so the settlers used to call the place 64. And yeah, the locals would say Sisibo. The Uganda railway was passing at, railhead was at Kibigoris. Eldoret is surrounded by prime agricultural land and acts as the trading center for the Uasin Gishu County, which is driven by large-scale grain farming, dairy, and horticultural farming. The town is also a local manufacturing hub with a number of nationally recognized manufacturing concerns, including Riplai, Rupa, Kenya Pipeline Company, Kenya Cooperative Creameries, as well as wheat and wheat and corn manufacturers within the town. So Eldoret is also home to Moi University, even though the main university is around 30 kilometers from the town, a place called Keses. So many of the constituent colleges of the university are located within the town. The town is also hometown for the numerous Kenyan runners, the most known of whom is Kipchoge Keino. Yeah, so many of them, one of the earliest, you know, Kenyan champions that, yeah, we still cherish to date. The high altitude within the area is also an ideal training ground for many middle and long distance athletes. And if you come to a place called Litani, you'll find a lot of people who come to the town just to, you know, exercise. Yeah, and the town has really, really grown over time. Within the town, you can also find Kipchoge Keino Stadium. Is the city of Eldoret is served by two aerodromes, Eldoret International Airport and the Eldoret Airstrip, very close to the town. Eldoret International Airport is a regional airport approximately 14 kilometers from Eldoret City. It is one of those towns that really grew over time, and it's mostly driven by farming. It was a town center where farmers would come and buy farm inputs, and to that it's still the same. And the more farming is growing in large scale, the more the business, the town is flourishing, the more athletes are winning gold and winning the cash. Most of them invest here. It's also a very good prime area to invest as business blossom very much in this city. So that is my first city, and the population of Uasin Gishu County is about 1.2 million as of 2019 census, and the town has a population of about 500,000 people. Yeah, so Eldoret is one of those towns that I'm sure in the next 5 years may be categorized as city. And yeah, it also has a lot of development that are coming up adjacent to the city, such as the bypasses that will really help in easing traffic, especially from the main road, Uganda Road. Yeah, it's a town that most truckers use on their way to Uganda, Rwanda, Burundi, Congo. Yeah, and with that, the town has really, really grown commercially and expanded. So that marks the end of my top cities. I don't know what, I'm sure most of you guys will still come with your own list. It's still allowed. So yeah, just share your list and let me know which town did you forget. And yeah, with time in future, we'll do another town. So yeah, with that, I hope you guys will enjoy. If you enjoyed, please hit the like button, subscribe to the channel as well, and share as much as possible. So peace out and have a good time wherever you are. See ya. Thank you.